Who gives this woman to be married this man?
I do.
I'm glad to be the officiant of this marriage. Before we start, I have to ask if anyone here can show just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together. Let them speak now, or forever hold their peace. Friends, we are gathered together in the sight of God to witness and bless the joining together of Anne Olanian and Brennan, Reuben Brennan. In a Christian marriage, the covenant of the marriage was established by God who created us for each other. With his presence and power, Jesus graced a wedding at Cana of Galilee, and in his sacrificial love gave us the example for the love of wife and husband. And Reuben come to give themselves to one another in his holy covenant. I ask you now, in the presence of God and these people, to declare your intention to enter into a union with each other through the grace of Jesus Christ, who calls you into union with himself as acknowledged in your baptism. Now I ask you, Reuben. Reuben, will you have Anne to be your wife, to live together in holy marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, and honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Good. Now I ask you, Anne, will you have Reuben to be your husband, to live together in your holy marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, and honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Good. Let us pray. God of all people, you show us the way, the truth, and the life. You sustain us with your Holy Spirit. We rejoice in your life in the midst of our lives. We praise you for your presence with us, and especially in this act of solemn covenant. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, now is the time for scripture reading.
If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, they will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part, but when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, that I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love.
Most of you can expect that I will say what I will say, because we just heard a famous passage about love, and you know that I am a pastor, and also that you have attended so many weddings. My mentor, whom I had deeply admired and respected more than 30 years, officiated my wedding. I remember that he gave an inspiring message, but I do not think that I remember more than that. You are right, I do not remember anything about the content of his message. I know I'm so stupid, but also the being nervous, following all other parts of the service, reception, greeting so many people, and rushing to airport for honeymoon. So I totally forgot what his message was. So based on my own experience, Ruben, I would like to share with you just one image that you can remember. Okay. We often think that marriage is something like looking at each other's eye with love, but it is not. Marriage is looking at same direction. And Ruben, just imagine yourselves standing on a hill on a wintry day, okay? Wind blows, snow falls, looking at same direction. You are holding each other's hand. It is very cold and tough to continue your journey. However, at least the hand you hold together, that much is warm. And that warmth makes you to keep your journey together. You also need to keep in mind that only when you put down the things you possess, your hand up free to hold each other's hand. In other words, while you hold something or doing something with your one hand, the other hand should be empty, completely for your spouse, to hold together and to continue your journey. Love is fantastic, but needs lots of works. Love is not a sentiment. Love is a will. Without love, we are nothing. Love is a very difficult job, but love never ends. Anne and Ruben, build up love together, looking at same direction with holding hands. You are friend, lover, companion, advisor, teacher, counselor, and mentor to each other. Today is a good day because you begin a new journey together. We bless you and will continue to pray for your beautiful life. Let us pray. Eternal God, creator and sustainer of all life, savior and giver of all grace, bless and sanctify with your Holy Spirit Anne and Ruben, who come now to join in marriage. Grant that they may give their vow to each other in the strength of your steadfast love. Enable them to grow in love and peace with you and with one another all their days, that they may reach out in concern and service to the world through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay. And then Brett, the Ruben, face each other, joining hands. First, I ask Ruben to Anne, and please repeat after me, Ruben. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Ruben Brenner.
I, Ruben Brenner.
Take you, Anne Olanian.
Take you, Anne Olanian.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to cuddle.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness or in health.
To love and to cherish.
to love and to cherish,
as long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I will trust you and respect you.
I will trust you and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh to you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
Regardless of the obstacles we will face together.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Okay. Now, Anne, please repeat after me. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I, Anne Olanian.
I, Anne Olanian.
Take you, Reuben Brenner.
Take you, Reuben Brenner.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I will trust you and respect you.
I will trust you and respect you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Laugh with you and cry with you.
Loving you faithfully through good times and bad.
Loving you faithfully through the good times and bad.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
Regardless of the obstacles we may face together.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Okay. These rings are the outward and the visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of Anne and Reuben in holy marriage. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may live in your grace and continue in your favor all the days of their life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Okay, please repeat after me. Okay. Anne Olanian.
Anne Olanian.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Reuben Brenner.
Reuben Brenner.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of my vow.
As a sign of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Please join your hands. You have declared your consent and vows before God and this congregation. May God confirm your covenant and fill you both with grace. Okay, please turn to the congregation. Now that Anne Olanian and Reuben Brenner have given themselves to each other by solemn vows with their joining hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are wife and husband in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Reuben, you may kiss the bride. O God, you have consecrated the covenant of Christian marriage. Send your blessing upon Anne and Reuben, that they may surely keep their marriage covenant, and so grow in love together, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts. Bless them in their work and in their companionship, in their sleeping and in their waking, in their joys and in their sorrows, in their lives and in their death. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God forever and ever. Amen. God the Eternal, keep you in love with each other, so that the peace of Christ may abide in your home. Go to serve God and your neighbor in all that you do. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and always. Amen. Okay, please stand as the age recess. Okay, please stand.
Please do me a favor. Let's all rise on our feet. This is to give honor to whom honor is due, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Ancient of Days, the I Am that I Am, the one that made this day to be possible. Father in heaven, we thank you. Our Lord and our God, every gift that we enjoy is from you. This day is a gift from you. The children whom we have joined together today are gifts from you. We thank you for every provision, Thank you for joining mercies. Thank you, Father God Almighty, for parents on both sides. As we all gathered here, Father, we commit everything, everything, from the start to the finish, unto your hands. Father, we pray that your peace will prevail in this place. That, Lord, everything will go well and according to plan. That this celebration will be memorable. That all that we do here today, Father, you will accept it as an act of worship. Father, we thank you. May you be honored, and may the joy be ours. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. And I
Together forever.
I see them blue from in you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue. What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do?
You can hear me say, yeah, yeah.
Good evening. My name is Jaka Conte, for those of you who don't know me, and for those who do, I go by Dean. I want to first give thanks to God for allowing us to be here on this beautiful day to celebrate the lovely couple behind me, Ben and Ann. Can we get a round of applause, please? And 2 years ago in March, right? But it feels like I've known her forever. I know, it's a little cheesy, everybody says that. I still remember the first thing that she said to me when we were at work, by the way, we met at work. I'm minding my business, right? I'm just walking. And she's like, hey, I like your hair. And I'm like, thanks. By the time I could even say thank you and process what she just said to me, she was gone. I'm like, oh, okay, no problem. And then finally, I mustered up the courage to ask her a week later if she would like to have lunch with me. Can y'all guess what she said?
No.
She said, ew, no. I'm just playing. She said, yeah. Can you see that, right? She was like, ew. But no, she didn't. So the conversation that me and Ann had over lunch made us so much closer, as if I'd known her, as if she was my missing piece. I know many people hear the term soul sisters, but I really feel that she's mine. She's the sweetest person I've ever met. Every time I have a tear or a worry, it doesn't matter if it's 2 in the morning, 3 in the morning, I'll just call her and she'll pick up. I don't want to stand here and say how great Ann is, because those of you who know her for yourself. Everybody has a unique story with her. And, let's just keep it to ourselves. I don't want to get you in trouble.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. From the first conversation we had, I've realized we have so many in common. Not only are we both females, both the firstborn African daughters. Can I get a woo-hoo? We know what the struggle is, but we will not speak of it. Over time, she was telling me her story, how she came overseas at a young age, and the more and more she talked, I just thought to myself, oh my gosh, two complete strangers, but our stories are so similar. I myself came when I was 8, overseas, not knowing a lick of English, but I just want to say, God puts everybody in your life for a purpose. We might not understand the reason now, but God is great. He makes no mistakes.
Amen.
Amen. Can I get an amen?
Yes.
And one of the most I'm so sorry. I'm gonna apologize again. She is one of the most selfless person I know. She didn't even know me, but yet she took a chance on me. And here we are today, and I'm made an honor. So for that, I really want to say thank you. I don't want to say everything because I'm going to stand up here and cry. But the love that I have for her is that she's my own big sister. And I really want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for everything that you do for me. Not just, taking me shopping. But everything from the advice that you give me, because when I first met you, the place I was in was not there. You are part of who I am today, and you made me part. part of the woman that I am today, and I want to thank God for that. We might have our disagreements. Disagreements, yes. But 2 seconds later, we're back arguing, talking as if nothing happened. I'm so sorry. And I just want to say, also, I love you from the bottom of my heart, and I love you with all my butt because it's bigger than my heart.
That's right.
That's right.
Can I get a yeah, yeah?
Yeah.
Saying I do at your wedding is by clicking the step box at the new piece of software on the computer for a phone without reading the terms, and the conditions. You do it despite having no idea what will come next, but together you will conquer. Congratulations on your marriage. You choose one another. May y'all continue to choose each other every single day, every single hour, every single second for the rest of your lives. May your household multiply and may your hearts never divide. May God bless y'all with many, many more years to come. May this not be y'all last year together. May your prayers be answered, all your worries be eased. May you be protected from all types of evil. Always remember to put God first and you will never fail in life. Thank you.
I wanted to start this off by commending Ruben for driving all the way from Cincinnati to Washington. Through both a flash flood warning and a tornado warning. So before he journeys back, I'm going to make sure to introduce him to Weather Radar. Speaking of journeys, Ruben and I have known each other since the 8th grade, so it's been a long time running. We met and became friends just instantly. We just had that connection. So as I stand here before you all today, it's just surreal. Surreal. As I've gotten to know you over the years, the one trait I recommend that just the best trait out of all I've seen is determination. You set your mind to it, you do it. It gets it done. An example of this is he told me his dream in high school, which was to become a traveling nurse. Well, he worked hard, and I was a traveling nurse. I actually lied. His first dream was to be a weatherman on TV, and his parents quickly squashed that. But the trait of determination must go hand in hand with responsibility for its own work. You have to be responsible. So Ruben studied, worked hard, and here he is. He's a man of perseverance. One of the stories to highlight this perseverance, responsibility, and determination goes back to his college days where he worked at a factory. It's about 15 miles away from his residence, not too bad of a drive. But one day, he can't find his car keys. But he has to get to work. So he's in a bit of a problem. What does he do? He hops on his bike and rides an hour and a half to the factory. I don't know how you can do it, but an hour and a half. But that just shows you the kind of man he is. He's not a quitter, you know. Something happens, he'll persevere through it. But as determined and responsible as he is, there's some craziness that goes along with it.
Amen.
He's a man full of surprises. And he's just a pretty interesting dude. Crazy hobbies, like he plays the accordion. I can count on my hand how many people I know can play the accordion, and he's sitting right there. But I remember one particular instance that was just, to this day, makes me laugh. So right before we're gonna hang out, he texts me, "I'm gonna cook goose tonight." Okay, goose? All right, never tried that before. I figured you went on a hunting trip or something. All right. I text him, "How was your hunting trip?" He said, "Oh, I didn't hunt, I ran it over." So I politely declined the roadkill, and we hung out, and I got the gun. Ruben's quite the character, and I'm happy for him to take this next chapter in his life. Now, Anne, I don't know you that well, but I can't wait to get to know you as your marriage prospers and grows. Before I propose the toast, I would like to read the Word of God. Hold tightly to what is good. Love each other with genuine affection and take delight in honoring each other. Never be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. Rejoice in our confident hope. Be patient in trouble and keep on praying.
Yes.
Romans 12:9-12. I propose this toast to Anne and Reuben. May your wedding be prosperous and everlasting.
Put your hands together for them. We're not done. They're going to feed each other. So we're going to see how the couple feeds themselves in private. So you're getting private access, ladies and gentlemen. They usually do this in I'm
say go daddy, go daddy, go.
This place is a endless. As if you say that don't.
So if you have not had a chance to dance with a couple, this is your time. We are creating memories here, ladies and gentlemen. Don't be left out of the memories we are creating for this beautiful couple.
It's been very heartwarming. We've had all positive things from everyone, and I just want to say thank you. But special thing goes to Richard Prast for the best man speech ever.
All right, that's all. Continue. Ever. Oh, yeah, Shreddy. Let's go.
Importante.